The break is almost as good as the show itself.
I know, Bird, right?
Having a great time.
Petri Bird is here with us. We are enjoying having you here. Thank you
great
for coming.
Conversation.
I just want to thank you for pronouncing my name right.
We study these things.
So many people call me Petri.
No, but no, but I remember Rob and Laura Petri.
Right.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Huh? She doesn't know. She doesn't know. Rob and Laura Petri. Dick Van Dyke Show.
That's okay.
Listen, even if you're acting, that's great. I would stick with it.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I've heard of that.
Yes, there you go. Years Columbia, old, Bird. How dare you, sir? Okay.
So funny.
Let's talk about, okay, because obviously we know you from, you know, the TV show, and you don't speak much in the show. You have a couple of lines here and there, but you're an actor.
I am.
And I want to talk about this film, American Skin.
Okay.
Explain to people what it is. How can they see it? What is it?
It's a film by an actor named Nate Parker. He was in Denzel's The Great Debaters. Played a great role in that. He did the film The Birth of a Nation. Mm-hmm. The second one, of mm-hmm. course not. And so I got a call asking me if I would be in his latest film. And Nate and I actually had a connection from somebody that we both knew who passed away of cancer. And so I wasn't sure of how I got the role or why I was asked to do it. But they told me it was going to be filming with Nate Parker, and I jumped at the chance. And it was a chance to play somebody out of character for me, which was a pastor. Mm-hmm. And the backstory is that a young black man gets shot. I think he's unarmed, and he's shot by the police. And in my scene, I'm the pastor, and I have convinced the mother to go on television mm-hmm. and calm the community down, you know, as opposed to getting it all riled up and, you know, and the community destroying itself over this issue, mm-hmm. But just to, you know, to have calmer heads prevail. And so I have a scene where I'm speaking to a group of reporters and, you know, kind of giving a powerful little speech as a prelude to her mm-hmm. actually coming out.
So what's it like to, like, stretch your acting chops in that regard?
Man, it's so good because in New York, I did off-Broadway acting, like way off-Broadway, like so far off-Broadway was in New Jersey.
Right. You know?
Come and see me if you have a day pass.
I'm in Hoboken so far. Yeah.
But I did that. I did stand-up comedy. I've done impersonations for years, and so it's always been in my blood to do acting and entertainment, and so for an opportunity to stretch out and, you know, and to actually speak.
Yeah. You know? Right. It's amazing.
Wait, did you say impersonation?
Yeah, no, that's what I was going to ask, because
who's your best impersonation?
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask, too.
Well, one of my favorite impersonations, dear, it's hard to believe, is what you call here, Archie Bunker.
Of all people.
Jeez, I know.
Archie Bunker.
I tell you, I'm all right now, but last week I was in rough shape.
Yeah.
You know, I asked my father, could I go ice skating on the lake? He told me, wait till it gets warm. And I do a couple of black people.
What a surprise. Things we didn't know about Bird.
I know, it's incredible. Okay, so no, obvious, the comedy and the acting, but this comedian in you, this lightheartedness in you, comes through on your social media
and on your series
with your wife.
Bonding with Bird.
Tell me about that.
Okay, my wife Makita is,
isn't she a producer on the show?
She's a producer on our show.
Yeah.
Okay, and that's where I met her. The second time, but we won't even go into
that. We won't even start there.
Anyway,
no.
Anyway, so Makita is slightly younger than me. Mm-hmm. Okay, some of you might notice if you see Bonding with Bird. Makita is 27 years younger than I am. And so it makes for a great chemistry between us because now I'm at the age where most men mature. Or at least able to.
He did a wink. He did a wink.
Wait, I got it.
You know what I'm talking about, Carlos.
We've already done the Dick Van Dyke thing.
I get it.
You know, but so and then Makita is she's special. She's different, and she's so funny. this is the thing about it, and this is what is making our marriage work and making every day such a wonderful day to be with her, is that she says things that are quotable, okay? So she reminds me of Judge Judy to a certain extent, because I will actually write down things that she says so that later on I can bring them in the to memory and laugh at them again, you know?
Awesome.
But it's funny, the chemistry between us is so wonderful, and we just decided, and it wasn't a conscious thing to do that. We were just laughing one day, and everywhere we go, everywhere we travel, we do video.
Right.
We do video. We do these little videos that we look at later on
hilarious.
And just laugh
great.
About,
yeah,
you know.
Great.
And, you know, we get other people involved. You know, it could be the person sitting behind us on the airplane, you know.
Yeah.
And they'll get involved with it, too, you know. So we decided to.
It's a great little series.
Yeah,
we decided to do.
Available on YouTube. Bonding with Bird.
Yeah. Bonding with Bird.
Well, we've been bonding with Bird, and it's been fantastic.
Thank you, Bird.
Thanks so much for being here.
Okay.
Thank you for having me.
As we leave, I just want you to say, ladies, have a seat. Do you know how you do at the end? Like after you've given the judge the case.
Right.
And you said,
into this camera.
Into that camera. Yeah.
Judge, parties have been sworn in. You may be seated. No, you. Be seated. Sit down. What's the matter with you? Jeez.
Thank you, Bird. Good to have you here.
We'll be right back.